Turkish faith. So major currency resets happening now. I'm going to go ahead and show you. This is the article that I've got posted. The video you're watching is going to be posted here as soon as it's up live. But let's just go over things real quick. So here's what's happened since Brexit. You can see the exchange rate between the US dollar and the euro. Now it looks like the euro is getting stronger. This chart is inverted. So what you're seeing is instead of one US dollar buying about, let's say, 68 in terms of the British pounds, now it's buying about 80.80. So almost one, it might get to that 1-to-1. I was reading some blog sites where they were saying that the euro, that they were saying that the British pound and the dollar could be at par. Well, we'll see if that happens. Okay, so I put some other links in the article. I'll just go and go over a couple. Venezuela's currency just had the biggest monthly collapse ever. All of these links will be in the main article, so just check it out, guys, when you have a second. The link is actually in the YouTube description right now. So the strong bolivar, their strong currency, has lost 45% of value in 1 month. Venezuela's currency, this is out of Bloomberg again, is collapsing on the black market again. Another one, congratulations to Venezuela. Bolivar notes are now worth less than it costs to print them. Now, we talk a lot about Venezuela because they're a huge oil exporting nation. So, you know, everyone's always talking about these currency resets, these countries with these large assets. Venezuela is one of those countries with a lot of assets. And look what's happening to their currency. Even their currency is not straight, is not being saved. Venezuela is printing a 20,000 Bolivar note. Now, what you guys need to know is they're actually pulling some of their banknotes off the street, which isn't really going to help their economy at all, but they started doing that. Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe printed these new $2 bond notes, $2 and $5 bond notes. That's one of the new things. And it says, and here's an article I posted, why bond notes can't save Zimbabwe and what ordinary citizens can do. Look at the new bond notes. They're already, the ink is already starting to smear off of these. And the government of Zimbabwe has already announced that they're going to be printing more. They've already decided, well, this was so successful, let's go ahead and print some more. So that's not going to work. Now, the funny thing is this. One of the original links I posted when I was going through my links to show you, it was actually pulled. It's like maybe their media pulled it down for some reason. But, I mean, I found an alternative source of it through the archive.org. And it was Zimbabwe's new bond notes are currently pegged one U.S. dollar, 40 bond notes on the black market. So they're talking about right here how they're not really that much have that much value. It says in 2009, after printing 100 trillion Zimbabwe notes, some of you guys still have that worthless currency. I still recommend you sell on eBay. It said 100 trillion Zimbabwe notes couldn't even buy a loaf of bread. And now I guess they're selling for like 50, 60 bucks on eBay. So at least you have an opportunity to sell those. Another big news out of India, their two largest banknotes, and you guys know I've been to India, their two largest banknotes, the 1,000 rupee and the 500 rupee, have been pulled. So if you have these notes anywhere in your home or whatever, get these on eBay, sell them as quick as possible. Wells Fargo won't take them, Chase won't take them, Bank of America, nobody's going to take these. If you can sell them on eBay, go ahead and sell them. I think you have till the end of the month to get them sold. So just try to do like a quick auction. And I'm sure there's a lot of people out there who speculate in foreign currency who aren't even aware that this currency has been demonetized. So if you have these two notes here, they are completely worthless. So please make sure you get rid of those if you have them. Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe increases the bond note withdrawal limits. This is another thing happening right now. Is they're dispersed, as it says. Let's see. This was the 20th. So this was about 5 days ago, and it says they dispersed more banknotes, these bond notes. So the bond notes that were just supposed to be kind of a limited distribution, now they're putting out $12 million more dollars worth of bond notes. So Zimbabwe could be headed to another hyperinflation. So if for you guys who are speculating, I do not recommend you buy the bond notes. And again, if you have Zimbabwe dollars, please get those sold on eBay as quick as possible before people catch on that they're worthless. Going back to what I said earlier about India, India pulled 86% of its cash out of circulation overnight. That was those banknotes I showed you right there. Guys, like I said, I've been to India. They do not use credit cards as like we do over here. Everything is pretty much cash. It's paper. Everything is paper. So they're trying to get rid of these notes, and they're going to introduce a 2,000 rupee note. So listen to that for a second. They're getting rid of these notes. They're going to put out a 2,000 rupee, and Bolivia is going to be putting out a 20,000 Bolivar note. So 20,000 for Bolivia, which, by the way, that's not going to be worth much soon because of their black market exchange rate. But that's happening anyways. So India pulls their currency. Bolivia's pulling their currency. Here's another thing. Iran plans to revalue and rename their currency. This is coming out of Reuters. Again, all the links are in the description of this article here. So just go through the article. You'll find the links inside. But listen to this right here. Iran plans to revalue its rial tenfold and revert to the currency's old name, the Toman, according to a bill approved on Wednesday by President Hassan Rouhani's cabinet, the official Islamic Republic news agency said. So it said the currency was called a Toman until 1930s, and most Iranians still refer to it by name. So that's something to keep in mind if you have Iranian rial, and a lot of you guys speculated on that. You may need to get rid of those currency notes too if they plan to pull those out of circulation. Here's out of Euronews.com. Again, Iran considers currency change. Iran to switch currency from rial to Toman. This is Press TV out of Iran, PressTV.ir. So very reputable news site. Iran is gearing to switch its national currency back to the Toman, a move that would end the reign of the rial after around 90 years and also could boost the value of the country's national currency against the U.S. dollar. So we'll see what happens with that. Out of Zero Hedge, the Aussie dollar plunges as inflation slumps to record lows. So despite surging commodity prices in China, which must be real and represent demand growth and price increases, right? Aussie core inflation slowed to the weakest on record as headline prices unexpectedly fell last quarter. So this is out of the ZeroHedge.com, a very good news source. And you can see what's happening with their inflation, just straight down, guys. Pound drops to the lowest since 1985 against as angst builds over Brexit. So a little bit of an older article. It's actually about 2 months old at this point, but I hadn't posted in a while. I want people to go over this. So the pound drops to a low, and I did obviously post that screenshot from my website, so make sure you take a look at that. This is when Brexit happened. You know, everybody thought for sure that England was going to stay in the EU, and it didn't. And literally immediately, the currency, you could call that a revaluation, whatever you want. It actually devalued. It lost a lot of percentage points. That's about a 20% drop if you guys actually compare from when Brexit happened till today. The British pound has lost about 20% of its value. So I would call that a reset right there. And finally, pound sterling falls to 6-year low against the euro. The pound is under pressure from fresh Brexit uncertainty. So all those articles are in there, guys. So I definitely want you to take a look at that. And for those of you who are watching, that's a bunch of you guys watching, please hit that thumbs up button if you like this video. I hope you do. The article is actually linked in the very beginning. It says click here for the new article and just click that button, guys. You'll be taken to the article. But again, I really appreciate everybody being on board. I hope you guys have a great new year. Hopefully I can get another video out before then. I know it's been a while since I posted, but just wanted to say that I hope everybody has a great new year, be safe, and if you have any questions, please reply to the comments in this video. Remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the newsletter. All the links are in the description. Thanks again, guys. I'll talk to you soon.